academies are important for students so that they get their post-secondary options in tying their academics to their real-world experiences. And academies provide that opportunity. Students get to go on field trips, they get to see their careers and speak with people in their career fields so that they can see how what they're learning in school becomes relevant to what they want to do either in college or what they want to do in their career.
And they also get exposure to different programs and stuff like that that they might want to try in college or they might not want to do in college. They can take the engineering, the video, the media, the computers, and kind of learn more skill sets to help them be better successful in college.
A bit of a heads up and gives them skills that they can apply later should they go on to engineering classes or any other kind of a class that's technical in nature.
Video production and the ability to communicate visually is incredibly important at all levels. So if you are somebody who is going to be an entrepreneur starting your own company and you have video production skills, then you are already farther along on your way and your road is much easier if you've got that skill set. Or if you're an entrepreneur and you want to hire somebody and you've got two people that are equally qualified and one of them has a certificate that shows that they have competencies in creating videos, well, then the pick is real easy. You want to go with that person who can add value to your company.
So for the 4 years, you know, we go through a bunch of different rigorous classes that pertain to what you like, really. There's the computer strand, there's the video strand, and also the engineering strand. I'm in the engineering strand, and basically what we pretty much focus on is, you know, either construction work, like say, for example, you know, in here, it's the wood, kind of like the wood shop almost, as you would say, but it's really the engineering room. You pretty much build a lot of different kind of objects that are kind of given to us as a project. We learn a bunch of different things here as far as, you know, how to use the tools properly, making sure you're safe as well while you are building. And also, you know, we get to work with different kinds of programs.
I teach the CAD courses here for our academies. In the engineering strand, we have two levels of CAD, 2D drafting and 3D drafting. And then we actually go into architectural drafting. The students, they learn the basics of 2D mechanical, and then they use those skills and apply it to the 3D world.
Well, one of the newest things that we've been doing in the class here is an electric car project. Electric cars are becoming more and more relevant these days. There are more companies are starting up to build electric cars. So one of the projects I have the kids do in the first level class is to design an electric car given parameters about how far it's supposed to travel in a certain amount of time. Then they learn about gear ratios, they cut the gears out on our laser cutter, they assemble the car and they test it to see how very close they come to making the car travel a specific distance and a specific amount of time.
We have two courses, chemistry and physics, for both STEM and green. In the chemistry course, we integrate water quality into the curriculum, where we'll go out and test the actual water at Stone Lakes Refuge. We evaluate it using parts per million testing. We'll use equipment like the Spark that we've been provided with, which actually will do pH, temperature, parts per million, and the students evaluate that according to the water quality reports for the EPA. In physics, we do a lot with energy and solar, whether it's the panels, light and sound transmission of energy, thermal energy, and we incorporate that with the engineering department and the CAD/CAM department, where we put that together to design a net zero energy house.
Hands-on learning is always, you know, better than just being able to learn something straight from a computer screen. You're learning it physically with someone that's there guiding you through if you need any assistance, if you need any kind of help while along that way, you know, kind of reaching your goal. Our teachers are pretty great about, you know, being there for you and kind of giving you that push that, you know, you can do this, you know, just because, you know, you're having this little, you know, stump right now, you're gonna get it and you're gonna, you know, pull through this and, you know, be successful.
I think I wouldn't have gotten as many opportunities to see what I actually want to do with my life when I get out of here. Because, yeah, I have science classes, but since I'm in the Green Academy, it's geared more towards the things I'm interested in.
They want to attend college. They know the opportunities that come in financial reward, job opportunities by going to college. So having that culture built into our school makes it more relevant for students. They see that, hey, if I have an interest in this, I've gotten exposure in high school, I see that I can actually make a career out of this, I enjoy it, and I know the best opportunities come for me if I do a post-secondary plan.
It also gives them, some of our academy programs have certifications and stuff like that, so if the four-year plan or two-year plan wasn't directly what they wanted, they could take some of those certifications and actually move on to a career, you know, this. And we have Apple interns, and kids get jobs, and they can decide what direction they want to go with those jobs or those certificates.
Through this academy, I was also able to get the Apple internship. We sort of gotten a first work experience. Not many people can say that, you know, they worked at Apple as a first job.
I would tell them you should join the Green Academy because it's so much fun. You get to meet so many new people. You get to play with so many cool gadgets and stuff, and you get to learn so many new things that you wouldn't in regular chemistry classes. And you get to go on a whole bunch of cool field trips. Like, I know they're coming up. There's a Great America field trip. And I went on the field trip to the California Academy of Science in San Francisco with my team.
I think that one reason is do it, because you're going to regret it. And you don't want to look back and, you know, look at your friends being in this program and, you know, having all these great opportunities as I had, or any of us other individuals had. And, you know, you're going to miss out on that great opportunity, because trust me, there's a lot of, you know, opportunities that open themselves up while you are in this program.
We'll be right back.